So in the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقُوا رَبُّكُمْ لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَأَرْضُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعَةً إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرُهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then mentions, after mentioning the fadl and the superiority of the people of knowledge, and that they're not like the people of disbelief and they're not like the people of ignorance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, Qul, say, Ya ibadi. So here's where he's addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Say, Ya ibadi alladhina amanu. Say to those who believe. O my slaves who believe. So articulate this to them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, commanding him to articulate to the believers, to the mu'mineen, those who believe, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اِتَّقُوا رَبُّكُمْ. Fear your Lord. لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَأَرْضَ اللَّهِ وَاسِعًا. So that they will be supported by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if they do righteous deeds and if they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that taqwa, as we mentioned, this is doing the awamirillah. This is fulfilling the obedience to Allah by being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing His commandments. And it is being away from His prohibitions, an-nawahi. So avoiding those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited. And here then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extols the virtue of hijrah, of making hijrah, of leaving the land of disbelief to the land of iman, or the land of bid'ah to the land of sunnah, or even the other type of hijrah that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, the hijrah of leaving your sins, as the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that that's one of the greatest forms of hijrah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if one is unable to make hijrah to a believing land from a disbelieving land, then at least what they're responsible for, and this is under all circumstances, because even in the believing land you can fall into the major sins and do the major sins, but the hijrah, which no doubt is an obligation upon all of us, is to make hijrah from our sins to obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, leaving off muharramat, leaving off disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the ard of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is wasi'a. You know, his earth is spacious. And verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the reward to the sabirun. He stores their reward for them. That those who are patient, who exhibit the qualities of sabr, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them the reward. You're going to get your reward in this life and in the next, or in this life or in the next life. بِغَيْرِ حِسَاب. You know, this cannot be accounted for, and it'll come in ways they can't imagine. This is all from the ni'am of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, to accept our good and forgive our evil. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.